हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टू थ्री. सो व्हेन यू एक्सचेंज दिस हाइड्रोजन इट इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म ES कॉन्फिगरेशन. वन कार्बन मीटिंग रिएक्शन यू आर गोइंग टू गेट CH2. सो इट एब्स्ट्रैक्ट्स प्रोटॉन टू फॉर्म कार्बेनियन. दिस कार्बेनियन अटैक्स हियर एंड लूजेस ब्रोमीन आउट. 3, 4, 2, 1. Option C is correct option, students. Next, the dihedral angle is going to be 180. Plus 1, 9. So just write down 9. Friends, we did all question answers. Let us submit score. Congratulations, students. You got all question answers are correct. You got 34 out of 34. Yes. Welcome to the series of computer-based tests of organic chemistry. Dear students, today we are going to solve this IIT JOM 2020 chemistry paper. Dear students, I have taken organic chemistry questions from IIT JOM 2020 chemistry paper and I made it into a computer based question paper. This question paper, if you want to practice in your phone or computer, I am providing this link just below of this video. You can click on this link. Let us see how to go there. Students, when you see this video in your phone or computer, I am giving the link to practice this test. Yes, just simply click on this link. I am clicking here. Yes, so it opens up like this. And so once it opens up, you can attempt this question paper in your phone or computer, and it is not going to ask your personal details like phone number or email or name. So no need to worry. You can attempt this question paper in your phone or mobile for number of times, and once you finish, you can have the option to view the score. Yes, students, these are all the questions appeared in IIT JOM 2020 question paper. IIT JOM consists of 3 sections, where section A consists of 30 questions, section B 10 questions, and section C 20 numerical answer type questions. The questions I have taken are from organic chemistry based questions. Section A. These questions will be 1 mark questions and there will be 1/3 of negative mark. Let us see the questions. Question number 4. Nucleobase not found in DNA is. Students, what is DNA? DNA is a deoxyribose nucleic acid. And the nucleic bases are thymine, uracil, guanine, adenine are given. So the correct option is uracil. They are asking not. Dear students, this is the key point of this question. The nucleobase not found in DNA. DNA will have guanine, adenine, thymine in place of uracil. DNA will have thymine and cytosine, whereas RNA, ribose nucleic acid, will have uracil in place of thymine. The difference between thymine and uracil is consisting of methyl group in thymine, whereas uracil will not have this methyl group. So the correct option not found in DNA is B, option B, uracil. Next. The correct statement for the following structures is, so they have given 3 compounds. So what are these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, 5 membered ring consisting of 4 nitrogens. And here 1 and 2. Yes, is it aromatic? This is aromatic. This is also aromatic. These 1 and 2 are resonance structures of each of them. And whereas 3, it is not aromatic and it is different from these two. Let us see the options. 1, 2 and 3 are resonance structures. No, students, so these two are only resonance, but 3 is not resonance structure, where carbon is having 2 hydrogens in these two options. 1 and 2, it is having only 1 hydrogen. So this option is not correct. The correct statement they are asking, students, 1 and 2 are resonance structures. Yes, this is correct. Whereas 3 is an isomer of 1 and 2. No, students, this is not isomer. Yes. So it is different. Yes. What is the best option? 1 and 3 are resonance structures. No, it is wrong. 1, 2 and 3 are constitutional isomers. Yes. These are structural isomers or metamers. And these metamers or structural isomers are also known as constitutional isomers. So the option D is correct option, students. Next. Question number 6. The correct order of boiling points of compounds 1 to 4 is. Yes, students. So the more the linear structure and more the molecular weight have high boiling point. Yes, n-butanol and isobutanol. isopropyl alcohol, diethyl ether. Diethyl ether is a low boiling point solvent, whereas this n-butanol will have more boiling point when compared to isobutanol. So 1 followed by isobutanol, followed by isopropanol, followed by diethyl ether. 1, 3, 4, 2. Option C is correct option, students. Next. So this is a straightforward question, students. Treatment of formic acid with concentrated sulfuric acid gives. So this is one of the best ways to prepare carbon monoxide at laboratory scale. Yes, students, take the formic acid. Formic acid is H, C, double bond O, OH. Formic acid, when you add concentrated sulfuric acid. Concentrated sulfuric acid, what it will do? It dehydrates, means it releases water from the substrate. Formic acid is HCOOH. So upon treating with concentrated sulfuric acid, it is going to give this carbon monoxide plus H2O. Yes, students? So the option A is correct option, students. Next. Yes, it is very, very simple if you know the RS configuration. Let us see the questions. The amino acid with R configuration is. Yes, students? So to denote the RS configuration, hydrogen must be downside in Fischer projection. So in all these projections, hydrogen is at right side. So how to bring it downside? Two exchanges has to be done. Let us see. So the best way to identify R configuration, let us give the numbering. This is nitrogen acid and CH2CS3. No problem. Let us give nitrogen. Yes, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is showing R configuration. When you do the exchange, two exchanges has to be done. One goes here, acid comes here, this goes here, this here. That means 1, 2, 3. So when you exchange this hydrogen, it is going to form S configuration. So A is not answer. Let us see B. So what is this? Number 1, number 2 here. Yes, students, number nitrogen is 1 followed by carbon. Yes, both carbon. When it comes to second attached atom is sulfur here. So this gets priority over acid. So amine 1 and thiol, since it is thiol, CH2CSH. So 1, 2 and 3. Yes, 1, 2, 3. It is showing S configuration. Now when you do the exchanges, two exchanges has to be done. So amine goes here, acid comes here. CH2CH goes here, hydrogen comes here. So amine, yes, here SH, then acid. 1, 2, 3, R configuration. B is correct option, students. Let us see other options also. So similar to this, 1, 2, 3. So this is not going to be the correct answer. Here, nitrogen 1, 2, 3. So it is showing R, so it is going to S. It is showing R, it is going to be S. So the correct option, which is the amino acid with R configuration, is option B. Yes, students, here you may get the doubt. Yes, phenyl and carboxylic acid. Yes, students. So C, double bond C, it will be the second atom, will be the double bond carbon, whereas here second atom is 2 oxygen. So acid gets priority over phenyl ring. Yes, students. So this is how B is correct option, students. Next. Section A. Among 30 multiple choice questions, from 11 to 30, you will get 2 marks to each question. As the wrong answer, you have to lose 2/3 of negative mark. Let us see the question. Question number 15. The major product formed in the following reaction sequence is. So what is this? Conjugated ketone. Yes. Conjugated addition of ethyl magnesium bromide. This is ethyl magnesium bromide is a Grignard reagent. Conjugate addition. So if it is not there, this is conjugation is not there, ethyl is going to attack here. But it is conjugated, it is going to be like this. This goes here, and ethyl nucleophile will attack here. 1,4 addition. Yes, students? So when this comes back, and here it is going to be double bond and ethyl. So double bond, ketone, ethyl. Double bond, yes, here, don't worry. Ethyl, double bond ethyl, here also double bond ethyl. So this is not D correct. This is 2 double bonds, not correct. So this is, no, this is not correct. And let us see this, chromium trioxide, dichloromethane. Yes, it oxidizes to double bond ethyl. So acid hydrolysis, like. So next, Wittig reaction. So this is carbonyl compound, and when you do one carbon Wittig reaction, you are going to get CH2. So this is CH2. To confuse you, they tilted this molecule like this. Yes, so carbonyl wrote here. Yes, students. So 1, 2, 3 position. So this is a carbonyl 1, 2, 3. Ethyl is here, double bond is here as it is, and this carbonyl is converted into alkene by Wittig reaction. So the option B is correct option, students. Next, question number 25. The major product formed in the following reaction is, so what is the starting material? Alpha haloketone. So alpha haloketones in presence of base undergoes Fieber-Esky rearrangement. So the usual conditions are taking only one alpha haloketone. Here they have given dihalogen constituted ketone. Yes, students. So Fieber-Esky rearrangement, it is undergoes elimination reaction to give alkene. Let us see the mechanism and what is the product. So the first step is sodium ethoxide. Abstract these protons. One of these protons. Let us abstract this proton. Yes, here there is no proton. Here it abstracts proton to form carbanion. This carbanion attacks here and loses bromine out. Yes, so now the intermediate is cyclopropyl ketone. This is the intermediate, cyclopropyl ketone. Yes, so now the second step is this methoxide. So methoxide anion is going to attack on this carbonyl compound and it goes here, and now it is O minus. Yes, students, this cyclic ring is there. Now when this O minus comes back to its original position, yes, so this has to break, or this has to break. So when this breaks, it is going to form this carbanion. So which is benzylic carbanion is going to be the stable intermediate. So when it opens up this side, it is going to form primary carbanion, which is unstable. So here it opens up this way. So it is carbanion. Now here CO, O methyl ester, it is ester, right? When this carbanion attacks onto this, and already there is one CC bond, when this carbanion comes here, this bromine goes out to form phenyl. Here methyl, here double bond, yes, and this is methyl ester. So let us see methyl ester. So this is methyl ester. Phenyl is here, carbon, methyl is here, double bond, and this is a CH2. Yes, so now CO, O methyl. Yes, students. So this is what option A is correct option, students. Yes, I am checking option A. What about other options? So it is not going to be, so phenyl, some migration is there. No, there is no question of migration or rearrangement of these substituents. So here also methyl, and here, so there is no methyl ring. So option A is correct option, students. Next. Yes, students, the rate of solvolysis of 1 to 4 follows. The solvolysis is when you heat the substrate at higher temperature using some solvent. Let us take water or some other solvent. It is undergoes elimination reaction. So elimination is favored when it is going to form some stable compound. Let us see. So this is bromide, this is bromide, this is bromide, and this is bromide. All are tertiary bromides or halogens. So let us take this. What is this? If it loses here, it is going to form carbocation. This carbocation, is it stable? Let us see. This is tertiary carbocation, but it is bridged carbon is here, so it is highly strained. Yes, so let us take this. So it loses bromine minus, and here it is going to form carbocation. Yes, this is stable, students. Alpha beta unsaturated carbocations are allylic carbocation. This is going to be the stable. So option 2 is going to be the stable compound. Next, this gives cyclopropene, a carbocation. It is going to be aromatic compound. Yes, 2 pi electrons. It is going to have 2 pi carbocation intermediate. So the more stable compound is going to be obtained from 3. So 3 may be the first, then 2. What about this? Students, it is going to form carbocation. Carbocation, cyclopentadienyl carbocation. No, it is not aromatic. It is non-aromatic compound, and this carbocation is not stable. Yes, students. So the option is 3 followed by 2. Yes, followed by 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1, 4. So the option C is correct option, students. Next. Number 27. The more stable species in each pair of conformers are. So what is this? First one is tertiary butyl equatorial. Yes, stable equatorial. Always this tertiary butyl takes in cyclohexane equatorial position is a stable position because it will have minimum torsional with other substituents. This is hydrogen, this is hydrogen. So it is stable conformation of this tertiary butyl in cyclohexane. So the first option one is going to be the more stable when compared to these two. Here it is axial, it is not going to hang like this. So one is more stable species among these two. Yes, so one is correct. Next, so option 3 and 4 among these three. Yes, this is, though it is looking like cyclohexane, but it is oxidated with oxygen. So when it is oxygen, yes, so it is equatorial here, but is having torsion with this methyl group. Both are downside, so it is going to have interaction with this methyl. So these two at same position, it is not going to be the correct option, students. Next, what about this? So this is 4. Yes, though it is down axial, yes, so it will not have any interaction with other substituents. This tertiary butyl group is going to be the stable, and whereas this, yes, it is away from this tertiary butyl. So this 4, compound 4 is going to be the stable. 1 and 4 are stable. Yes, let us take this 1, 4, then 5 and 6. Among 5 and 6, what is the option? Yes, so here it is axial, but it is going to form hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding is possible here, students. So let us write hydrogen here, and this oxygen, and this oxygen. So internal hydrogen bonding is possible when this is taking this axial position. Yes, so it can form hydrogen bonding. Whereas this 6, yes, it is very far, and these two oxygens are this side and this oxygen is here. So there is no question of hydrogen bonding. So in of internal hydrogen bonding formation, this conformation 5 is going to be the stable. 5, 4, 1, 1, 4 and 5. These options 1, 4, 5 are going to be the stable. So which is showing that 1, 4, 5 option B is correct option, students. Next, number 28. The major product formed in the following reaction sequences. Dear students, it is straightforward question. Titanium trichloride, whenever you see this copper coupling under reduction condition, zinc copper couple, or sometimes you may get LAH, that is lithium aluminum hydride, or some other reducing agent. So titanium trichloride, aldehydes or ketones undergoes self-condensation to give alkene. Yes, dimer of alkene. So this is final compound. So it is going to form, the first step it is going to form this double bond, and then remaining group will be the same this side. So dimer you are going to get. What about this HCl and water? Yes, HCl and water, this hydrolyzes this methyl ether. Yes, methyl ether hydrolyzes to give this ketone. HCl water gives demethylation to give ketone here. Ketone 1 is ketone, and here there will be no double bond. No double bond. Then here phenyl, and this is carbonyl. Then this is the compound here, carbon, and here CH. So here double bond. So CH2 CO phenyl. Option C is going to be the correct option, students. Here no, this double bond should be no. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 carbons this side, and another 3 carbons that side. Means 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Yes. So option C is correct. What about this? 1, 2, 3. So where it has come this? No, this is not correct. This is also not correct. Option C is correct option, students. Next. Question number 29. For the Diels order reactions 1 to 4, the activation barriers follow the order. Yes, students, activation barrier means the reaction to undergo which requires minimum energy or heat. Diels order reaction takes place between diene and dienophile. Here, these are the dienes. Yes, cyclopentane diene. This is furan. Yes, it is diene. Yes, pyrrole, it is diene. It is thiophene diene. Yes, among these four compounds, so this is dienophile, stress. This is dienophile. So among these four compounds, which is electron donating group sulfur, nitrogen, oxygen and carbon. Among these four compounds, electron excess compound is sulfur or thiophene. Yes, this is thiophene. So the compound which is having electron donating substituents in diene is undergoes under minimum energy conditions. So thiophene followed by nitrogen oxygen, which is easily gives nitrogen electron excess. Yes, this nitrogen compound undergoes easily. Yes, 3 followed by 4 followed by 2 followed by 1. Yes, so oxygen and carbon, obviously oxygen compound undergoes easily than this carbon containing compound. So 3 4 2 1, which is option 3 4 2 1, option C is correct option, students. Next, question number 30. The major product formed in the following reaction is, what is the reaction? Yes, iodine halogenation, alkene halogenation. What it takes place? It takes place trans halogenation, trans addition takes place. Yes, so this is iodine and there will be a intermediate, then this next attacking iodine will attack from opposite direction, so the trans iodine will be formed here. No doubt it is not stereoisomer, they have given cis and trans, there is no question of this. And when you add this sodium bicarbonate, this carboxylic acid going to lose H plus ions and O minus. This O minus attacks on iodine containing this carbon, elimination is going to take place. So let us take, this is the compound. It is condition is that iodine and iodine. So this carbon, if it is above the side and the new forming this O and carbon O or ester bond must be above the plane. Yes, so same plane, same side. Yes, no problem. This is going to be formed. So this is going to be formed. So this is not going to form. This is not going to form. Among these two, yes, among these two possibilities A and B, what about iodine? Yes, iodine also no problem, whether it can attack here or from attack here, no problem. But when it this oxygen is coming from this side and the leaving group is down, let us say downside, this upside or above the plane iodine will not allow to enter from this side. Yes, it will not allow to enter from this side, this iodine will block. So iodine must be below the plane. So this is option B is going to be the correct option, students. It is very simple, students. This iodine is trans to this, so that is why it is going to form this compound. Yes, so option B is correct option, students. Next, section B. Yes, students, in section B you will have 10 multiple selection questions. This is very very important concept, students. You have to choose more than one option, or it may be sometimes only one option. So, and if it is more than one and you choose only one option, there is no question of partial marking. You will not get any marks. Let's see the questions. Question number 37. A chiral stereoisomer or isomers is or are possible for A chiral. Dear students, alanes, this is alane. Alanes are stereoisomers, optically active. Yes, because of this consecutive double bonds, it is not going to be planar. It is not going to be planar and it is going to take this opposite direction. It is not going to be a chiral. It is chiral molecule. It is a chiral molecule. They are asking a chiral. The key point is a chiral. So don't choose this alene molecule. Yes, students. So this is biphenyl. Biphenyls will go isomerism. Yes, stereoisomerism. It is not going to be the achiral, it is chiral. This is chiral bond. This is chiral bond. Because of this bromines, it is not going to be planar. And so B is not going to be correct. What about C? Yes, C is showing 1, 2, 3, 4. So this side, yes, these compounds will have stereoisomers, but it is symmetric compound, meso compound. If I draw the line here, OH here, and two offs are same mirror images, it is going to be the meso compound. So it is going to be the achiral molecule. Yes, students, so option C is correct. When it comes here, yes, simply you can draw the line like this, mirror image, and it is going to be achiral compound C and D, option C and D. Let us check option C and D. Yes, students. Next, The compounds are compound which will have only two signals in the proton NMR spectrum in 3:2 ratio is R. Yes, students. So compound A, how many signals are expected in this compound? So these two are same. So one, let me write one signal for these three protons. This is one signal and this is one signal. Three signals are going to be expected for this compound A. They are asking only two signals. What about this? 1, 2 and 3. 3. So A and B are not going to be correct. What about this? C? Yes, this is one signal and this is one signal. Yes, this methyl and this methyl same. And this proton and this proton is same. So only two signals. Yes, condition 1, two signals. Then what is the ratio? So this is 3 and how many? 2 protons. 3:2. So 6:4 or 3:2. So option C is correct option. Yes, let us check C. Next D. What about this? 1 and 2. Only 2 signals, students. Yes, 1 and 2. Only 2 signals. So D is correct. How many protons? 3+3, 6. 2+2, 4. 6:4 or 3:2. So option C and D. These two are correct options, students. Next. Question number 39. The correct sequence of reactions for the synthesis of the following molecule is. So how to prepare this? 4-iodophenol. Phenol, when you add magnesium ether, though it forms RMGX, is it going to be stable? In presence of phenol or alcohol or water, this degrades. So RMGX or Grignard reagents are not stable under the presence of phenols, alcohol or water. So the first step is not going to take place. A is not correct. Yes, students, let us see option B, cyclopropyl bromide, magnesium and ether. Okay, RMGX it is going to form. 4-hydroxybenzaldehyde. When you add this RMGX in presence of 4-hydroxybenzaldehyde, that 4-hydroxy is nothing but alcohol or phenol. It is not going to be the correct option. So let us see C, option C. 4-iodophenol, cesium carbonate, methyl ether, THF. Okay, no problem. First, they are going to protect this phenol. Methyl ether is going to be formed in first step A or 1. Next, they are adding to that iodo compound, they are adding iodobenzene, they are adding magnesium ether. Yes, it is going to form this iodo magnesium ether. So, this total R Mg iodide. So step 2, it is going to form this cyclopropane carboxaldehyde. Yes, this is carboxaldehyde. It is aldehyde. When you add RMGX, it is going to form this. Option C is correct, students. What about D? Cyclopropyl bromide. Yes, cyclopropyl bromide. Magnesium ether. Yes, RMGX. Methyl 4-methoxybenzoate in THF. So ester, methyl ether is there. 4-methoxybenzoate. Yes, ester. No, students. Option C is correct option, students. Next. Number 40. The organometallic reagent or reagents among the following is R. Lithium divinyl cuprate. What it is? It is Gilman reagent. Lithium divinyl cuprate. Gilman reagent. Lithium diisopropylamide. LDA. Is it organometallic? Students, it is going to act as a base. Potassium tertiary butoxide. It is a base. It is not going to be the organometallic reagent. Isopropyl magnesium iodide. What it is? Grignard reagent. So option A and D. These two are correct options, students. Next. A and C. 20 numerical answer type. Dear students, these questions you have to answer number. You have to write only number. Don't write ONE1TW2. Just and among these 20 questions, the first 10 questions carries each one mark. Yes. Let us see the questions. Question number 48. Total number of constitutional isomers possible for the trimethyl cyclohexane is? So trimethyl cyclohexane. Let us write cyclohexane here. Cyclohexane. 1, 2, 3 methyls. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 trimethyl cyclohexane. 1 isomer. Yes. So this 3 methyl I am going to substitute here. Yes. 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 4 isomer. 2. 1, 2. If I write here, it is going to be 1, 2, 3 again. So, this is not going to be the correct. So, what I will do is, here I will keep alternate 1, 3 and 5. 1, 3, 5 isomer. These 3 isomers are possible. Yes, next. So, other possibilities is, they did not ask whether it is 1, 1 dimethyl. Yes, I can, let us write 1, 1 dimethyl. Yes, 1, 1, 2 trimethyl cyclohexane. So this is fourth option. So when it is 1, 1, let us write 2, 3 here. 1, 1, 3, 1, 1, 3. Other one, 1, 1, 4. Six isomers are possible. So let us write 6. Yes, students. So just type 6. Next question number 49. The dihedral torsional angle in degrees between the two methyl groups in the most stable conformation of n-butane. It is simple example, students, is round off to nearest integer. So how to write n-butane? Newman projection. Newman projection, how to write? Let us write here this, and let us write this methyl here, and these are two hydrogens. And when you write here methyl, it is trans to each other. Two methyls are trans to each other. So the dihedral angle is going to be 180. Right, students? Or even if you write in a linear form, methyl this way and this way, this is a trans to each other. Methyl is here, methyl is here. So what is the dihedral angle? 180 degrees. Just write 180. Don't write degrees or zero. Don't write anything. Just type 180. Yes, students? Next. The degree of unsaturation or double bond equivalent for a compound with molecular formula C14H12O2 is, what is unsaturated or double bond equivalent? If you take any compound, the number of hydrogens required to make it saturated. So double bond equivalent, what is the formula? Double bond equivalent equal to C minus half of the hydrogen, that is H/2 minus H/2 plus, if it consists nitrogen, let us write nitrogen by 2. So don't worry about nitrogen, just strike off. Plus 1 C minus H/2 plus 1. So what is the carbon? 14 minus H/2 means 12/2, how much? 6. 14 minus 6, 8. So what is left over? Plus 1. 8 plus 1, 9. So just write down 9. Next. Number 59. The total number of tautomers possible for 1 and 2 together is. So what is the option? Yes, students, this is 1. Isomers is. Tautomers 1 is possible. So 1 is already in our hand. Let us write keto enol form. This is enol, this comes here and this lone pair comes here. 1 double bond, here double bond OH. So this is 1 tautomer. Already 1 is in our hand. So 1 tautomer has come. Now what happens? This goes here, the double bond which is here comes here, and this lone pair comes here. So what is the compound now? Double bond OH, double bond OH, here double bond. Yes, so 3. From compound 1, you will have 3 tautomers. Let us see. So now we have 3 in our hand. Next, 2, compound 2. Yes, it is differently substituted. Here it is methyl, here it is phenyl. Yes, students. So the same, let us write first option this way and this way. Yes, this is alcohol, this is amine. So one compound, and already this is 1, means total 2 we have from here. Let us do next. So when it is having double bond O, and this comes here, and this comes here, and here. So now how many? 6. Yes? So the next option, here it is going to, we get other compound. What it is? Instead of this bond, enolization, let us do this bond, enolization, enolization, enolize. So this is different. So 4 compounds we are going to get from here. From here, 3 compounds, 3 plus 4. 7. Let us write 7. Yes, students. Next. Yes. Next. Question number 60. The total number of head to tail isoprene linkages in the following molecule is. They are asking isoprene linkages, students, not units. So the keyword of this question is linkages. Let us see the how many linkages are there head to tail. Yes, what is isoprene? Yes, 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. When it is polymerized to give this compound, this is what it is. It is squalene, students. So how many head to tail isoprene linkages? So this is head and tail. So this is tail. So this is head to tail. This is one isoprene. This side is 1. So again, this is head and this is tail. 2, students. So this is 2. 1, 2. Next, head, to tail. Head to tail. Yes. So this is what it is. No, it is not tail. This is not head and tail. So this is tail to tail. This is tail of this. This is also tail of this. So this is tail tail link. They are asking head to tail. This is also very very important, students. So head to tail. This is one and head to tail. Yes, one and two. This is not head to tail isoprene linkage. So this is not going to be the counted. One and two. And let us come from this side. Head and this is tail. Yes, this is head and tail. Head to tail. One and this side. This is head and this is tail. Head to tail. This side two. This side two. This side two. So the total isoprene linkages, head to tail isoprene linkages, is four, students. Yes. So it is very very typical question. Don't confuse this head to tail. So don't count this bond. It is going to be five. At the same time, if it is asked units, it is going to be six. While in this type of questions, be cautious, students. So the correct answer is number four. Let us submit four. Yes, students, we did all question answers. Once you did all these question answers, you can go back and check the answers. Yes, students. Yes, there is option to go back and check. Yes, it is exactly prepared identical to your original test. Where there is, students, one key point answering this computer based test. Dear students, to go back or front, don't use arrow keys on board. Yes, example, I am using arrow keys. So this is, I am using arrow keys. It is going to move the answer. So please don't use arrow keys on your board. So use only mouse to tick the correct options. Yes, students, we did all question answers. Let us submit. Yes, students, once you submit, your response has been recorded. You have option to view score, see previous responses, submit another response. Let us see view score. Congratulations, students, you got all question answers are correct. You got 34 out of 34. Yes, students, let us see the options. Yes, question number 4, the nuclear base not found in DNA is uracil. The correct statement is 1 and 2, 3 are constitutional isomers. The boiling points follows 3, 1, 3, 4, 2. Yes, this is carbon monoxide water and R isomer is B. This is not reaction followed by Wittig. Option B is correct. This is Favreski rearrangement. Option is correct. This is the alkene. We are going to get Favreski rearrangement. The rate of solvals is follows the more stable compound. This is cyclopropene carbocation. Yes, which is aromatic 3 followed by 2 followed by 1 4. Yes, and these are the compounds which is the order of stability. Then this is McMurray reaction where you are going to get alkene. Option C is correct. This is Diels order reaction. Option C is correct. And here you are going to get B. The chiral molecules are C and D. Question number 38. What is the correct option? Yes, C and D. Two signals only are possible for C and D. The correct sequence? Yes, students. Option C. Question number 40. Lithium divinyl cuprate and isopropyl magnesium iodide. And Grignard reagent. So total number of constitutional isomers 6, 180, 9. Yes, next 59. Yes, 7. It is correct. 60 isoprene linkages, head to tail isoprene linkages are 4. Yes, students, this is how you can check all your answers also. Yes, students, this is how you can check your question answers. Complete and submit the paper. Yes, students, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel Venus Academy if you are not yet subscribed. And don't forget to click on like button and bell button. We'll meet again with new question paper, with new questions. Bye. Sayonara. All the best.